Have you ever seen any of these errors before and wondered, what do they mean? What should I do? Well, these are all common PI security errors. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to test if you can connect to your PI data archive successfully, to check how you actually connect, and to recognize if you're running into a security permissions issue. So often if you don't have sufficient permissions to connect to or do a specific task on the PI Data Archive, you'll receive one of these errors. And as you can see, there are different errors that might show up. So let's look at some of the similarities so we'll be able to recognize the security error when we see them. You'll notice that many of the errors start off with the 104 number. And if we look at the wording in the error messages, we'll see similarities indicating maybe no access or missing a trust or identity mapping or talking about authentication, permissions, rights. Another thing that you might see is that if you're trying to look at data and you see no data, this could be an indication that you don't have enough permissions to see the data. Keep in mind that no data may also be reported in a PI client if there is no data for that time period. So now that we have an idea of some of the common security errors, how will we actually see them when we're using our software? Well, if we're trying to look at data with PI client tools like PI DataLink or PI ProcessBook or PI Coresight, we might see a message that indicates that we don't have read access, or we might see messages saying no data. And if we checked with someone and we know that the data does exist during this time period and we see no data, that's telling us that we don't have permissions to see the data. Additionally, if we are involved with setting up PI interfaces to collect data and send it to our PI data archive, there's a couple important security things to keep in mind. If we are working on configuring our PI interface using the PI Interface Configuration Utility, PI ICU, we have to make sure that our user has permissions to write to the module database. And if we don't, then we'll hit an error message like this. Now, keep in mind that connecting with the PI Interface Configuration Utility is separate than the connection that the PI interface itself makes to the PI Data Archive. And for that connection, to see if it's successful or look for any errors, we need to look at the message logs. And if we look at the message logs on the PI interface machine, and the interface is unable to access the PI point table when looking for PI points, we would see an error message like this, indicating there's a permissions issue. Or if it has issues writing to specific PI points or tags due to a lack of permissions, we would see messages similar to this. If we're involved with configuring PI points, we might be using tools like PI Builder. And if we try to edit something and we don't have permissions to actually make those edits, then we might receive a pop-up message similar to this. And in addition to PI Builder, many configuration items on the PI Data Archive are done with PI System Management tools. In PI System Management tools, if we try to edit something and we don't have permissions to edit it, again, we'll see an error message like this pop up. Keep in mind that these error messages popping up when we're trying to do specific tasks are because we're trying to edit and save something that we don't have permissions to. Now, what would happen on the other hand if we're just trying to see maybe some settings and we don't have permissions even to see the settings? In that case, it's not necessarily the case that an error would pop up. We might just receive basically a blank screen. We would not be able to see the things that we don't have permissions to. However, keep in mind if you're working with PI System Management tools, down at the bottom in the session record, there will still be an error reported. Now, any unsuccessful connections on the PI Data Archive, these messages will get logged in the PI message logs. So in this case, we might see PI message logs that indicate issues. And lastly, the PI SDK utility is a handy application that we can use to test connections to the PI Data Archive. And if we are unable to connect with a mapping or a trust, we will receive a message like this one, letting us know that we are unable to successfully connect to the PI Data Archive. So now we have an idea of what security errors look like. What should we do to troubleshoot one if one comes up? Well, there's a couple things that we can do. As a user, we can see, one, can we connect at all to the PI Data Archive? And if we can, how did we connect? How did we authenticate? Which basically it comes down to, what identities do we receive? And we can actually look at these things using the PI SDK utility or the connection manager in our clients. And we'll see specifically how we can do that. Once we have those items figured out, then we'll have everything we need to go to our PI system administrator and let them know what the problem is. We'll be able to say, I was trying to do this task, this is the error that I received, and it looks like a security issue. Now, I can connect to the data archive, or I can't, and if I can connect, this is exactly how I connected. From there, your PI administrator will be able to help determine what permissions do your identities have on that data archive, and what permissions are needed to actually do the task that you were trying to do, and basically what's missing, right? What additional permissions do you need? They can grant them to you, and they'll also be able to help you determine if the correct connection protocol is being used on your machine. So let's see how we can complete these two items on our client machine right away. So I switched over to this machine, and this is a machine that Lucy, one of our engineers, is using. And if Lucy wants to be able to see if she can successfully connect to the PI Data Archive, as I mentioned, one handy way that she can check right away is to use the PI SDK utility if she has it installed on her machine. So let's search for that by typing SDK, and we'll see About PI SDK show up. And if we select this, we can open the PI SDK utility. And to check to see if she can connect to this PI Data Archive, she just needs to check the box next to it. Okay, so we can see that down here, she was able to successfully connect, and we also can see what are the identities, users, or groups that she receives. So this is letting us know that Lucy was able to successfully connect, and we can even see that Lucy has her account here, which is L-Engineer. Now, what would it look like if a user was unable to successfully connect? Let's switch. So in this case, we have another user, and when this user connects, they receive this message. So basically, the error letting them know that there's not a mapping or a trust that is allowing them to authenticate on this PI Data Archive, that they are unable to connect. They hit OK, it will say down here at the bottom that the connection fails. So that's what it will look like if you can't make a connection from the PI SDK utility. So let's jump back to Lucy and ask, if we can connect with the PI SDK utility, what does that mean for our other client tools? Since Lucy is authenticating with a mapping, which is the preferred authentication here, we will see the same behavior in PI ProcessBook, PI DataLink, PI System Explorer, and PI System Management tools. Let me show you that here. So if we go to PI ProcessBook, we can also directly, in this client tool, check the connection if we go to connections, and you'll see the same type of dialog box. And I'm already connected, and I can also test the connection again here. If I expand this, again, we see the same information that Lucy was able to connect successfully and is receiving the all company and process engineers. Similarly, we could do the same process in other client tools. For example, in PI DataLink, we can go settings and also open the connection manager. Now, in this case, you can see that I'm already connected because it has this green dot. And if I hover over it, it will report how we're connecting as. And we'll also see that same user reported here. If we were not already connected, or to disconnect and try connecting again, we can right-click and hit disconnect, and similarly connect again. The same dialog window is also available when we're looking at PI System Explorer. Same thing here. And in PI System Management Tools, once we have selected a plugin, we'll see the connection information down here at the bottom. And because multiple PI identities may be received, if we don't see all the information because it's too long, we can always double click and open this. So again, we see the information here that Lucy is receiving these identities. We know that it's using this Windows account, and we can also get some information that she's actually connecting with a mapping. And we know that she's connecting with the mapping as well in the other tools because they're reporting her user account here. So now we've been able to test our connection to the PI Data Archive with the PI SDK utility, as well as our other client tools. And we know how to check if we're receiving a mapping and what PI identities that we receive from that mapping. Now there's one other PI client tool that we haven't talked about yet, and that's PI Coresight. So remember, PI Coresight is web-based. So what that means is that we're connecting to the PI Coresight server through a web browser. This also means that we're not going to be able to see the information on the connection on the browser because that information is actually getting logged on the Coresight server itself. So when we're working with PI Coresight, we'll need to have our PI administrator check to see how specifically we're connecting. And that's something that they'll be able to do using PI System Management Tools Network Manager Statistics. So with that, just remember, when checking for a security issue, make sure to determine if you can connect to your PI Data Archive, and if you can, how did you connect? And from there, you can give your PI System Administrator the information that they need to determine what access permissions you might be missing. And if you're a PI System Administrator, stay tuned for our next video where we'll show how we can leverage Network Manager Statistics to troubleshoot connections from all of our different users and applications.